I noticed that in this assembly, all the components are fully constrained, but this should actually be a mechanism. The components should be capable of rotation, and we should have some gears in here. So I'm going to start off by taking the first subassembly and correcting it to have a mechanism connection. So let's edit definition. And so if I go to the placement tab, you can see that it's got two coincident constraints. They've got this allowed assumptions. A lot of times you can uncheck the allow assumptions and then click on this button and have it convert over to the proper mechanism connection. But in this case, it somehow figured out that I want to have a general connection, but that's not true. I want a pin connection. A pin connection allows one rotational degree of freedom. So let's get rid of this constraint in here and change from general to pin. And first off, I'm going to select two axes or cylindrical surfaces to align. And so let's select this cylindrical surface, and I'll grab this cylindrical surface from the assembly. And then to eliminate translation along that axis, I'm going to pick two surfaces in here. And by default, it's going to make them coincident, but I actually want a distance between them. I happen to know that the distance between this surface and this surface over here is actually supposed to be 2.5. So let's correct that. So that's good. It says my connection definition is complete. If you wanted to, you could go to the rotation axis and define planes for the component 0 and the assembly 0. But since this subassembly should be capable of 360 degree rotation and it's got axial symmetry, I really don't see any point in doing that. So let's hit the check mark to complete our placement. If you take a look at the component in the model tree, it's got a glyph next to the name, and that glyph has a box with a dot inside of it. That indicates that there is a mechanism connection. Let's create a motor and run a kinematic analysis. So I will click on Applications and then Mechanism, and we have an indication that we have a pin connection in the model. To create a motor, I'll go to servo motors. And for the reference entity, I find the easiest way to select the joint axis is by expanding the joints to the connections and then selecting the rotation axis. And then for the profile, I'm going to define an angular velocity. And I'm going to keep it low just for the sake of this analysis. Let's do 360 degrees per second and hit the check mark. Now let's define a mechanism analysis. And rather than doing the default position analysis, I'm going to use the true kinematic solver. And let's just run this for 4 seconds, cut down on the time. And then from the motors tab, make sure that my motor is in here. Now let's click the run button. And there we can see the rotation. By the way, you have a progress bar down at the bottom of the screen. Now that the run is complete, let's click the OK button. And we have playbacks available. You can right click on the playback and hit the play button. And from here, we can crank up the speed and we can hit the play button to watch the motion over and over again. But I'm going to stop that and also show you that from the capture button, this allows you to generate an MPEG movie out of this, and you can even photo render it. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more information, please visit www.creowindchill.com. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and click the subscribe button to be informed when new videos are uploaded. Thank you very much.